Right, and we are back. So in the last video, we got the wooden panels. We got our wood broken up into a series of panels by combining two normal maps together, and also by adjusting our base color a little bit to create some darkening in the location of the gaps of those panels. So now what I want to do is get a little bit clever with our base color so that we can create the effect of some of these wooden panels actually having different colors. Now, as a recap, if we take a look at this ceramic tile texture, it is broken up into a series of channels. So here's red, which just shows the gaps. Here is green, which shows some of the tiles selected. And here is blue, which shows some other tiles selected. So we're going to make use of that information. So let's go back over to our material. Here is how we are going to do that. We're going to use a couple of different linear interpolates, but we're going to chain them together. So I guess let's begin. I'm trying to think of the best way I want to do this. Yeah, I like this. Let's start off by just making a linear interpolate that goes between the original color of the wood and another color that we would like to change. It could be of any value we wanted to. We'll just make like a little node that just holds a random color, and we'll just set it up that way. So for starters, let's move our nodes around a little bit. So this is the guy who defines the actual color of our wood. Now let's make a node that holds another value. And if you remember, we called that a 3 vector. You can hold down the 3 key and just click to hold to create one of those. And let's say we use a mostly saturated red. Something about like so. So we have a red value. Now here's where things start to get a little bit fun. We don't want our red panels to just be red. We still want them to maintain at least a little bit of the actual wood texture, just something to make them feel a little more wooden. So what we'll do, actually, okay, hang on. I'm going to back up. I'm going to overcomplicate this material way too quickly. So we'll just go between red and wood right now, because here's the thing. If I just plug red in here, the normal map is still going to give us some nice, you know, indentation that looks kind of like wood. We could get kind of clever and combine colors in a lot of different ways, but I'll avoid that just to keep this video from going off the deep end. But I do really like it when videos go off the deep end. So let's just combine these together via a linear interpolate. So I'll hold down the L key and click. And we'll say that the color for black, which is going to be the value for A, that will be our original wood. The value for B will be our red paint. Now, wires are going to start crossing. Things are going to start getting a little bit messy. Don't let that alarm you. That's pretty common. That is going to happen. Now we need something to drive alpha. We're going to use the green channel, which just allowed us to select some of the tiles of this result. We'll use that to drive alpha, and let's take a look at our final result. So you can see it's mostly wood, with some of the panels actually selected and turned red. We could just plug this straight into our base color. However, the problem is we lost that coloring we were getting in between each one of our tiles. So instead of plugging it into base color, we're going to plug it into the result of our multiply right into B. So it's actually going to replace where that wood was plugged in. And I'll try to space things out so you can at least see where all the wires are going. About like so. So some of these tiles have now been painted red. Okay, so if we really wanted to be super awesome and amazing at this, I wasn't gonna do this, but I'm gonna do it now anyway. Let's take our red color, we'll drag a wire off, we'll type multiply. We're gonna take our red channel, which is, it's just a grayscale. If you wanna preview it real quick, we can come into our wood texture and just show red. So there's what red actually looks like. So it's just a gray that's still got a lot of the detail from the wood grain in it. We're gonna use our red channel and multiply that by our red color, and we'll plug that into the B of our linear interpolate. But take a look at what the result does. Now we get some darkening in those red panels. We give them, in effect, a lot more life. So again, that's just taking the red channel from our texture, multiplying that by our red color, and plugging the result of that into the B input of our lerp, and then taking the lerp and plugging that into the B input of our final multiply. And if you're not scared yet, don't worry. Actually, the material is still very simple. So if you want to pause for just a second or do a little bit of rewinding and catch up, you can totally do that. All right, so the next thing we're going to do is take a few more of these tiles and make them an entirely different color. To do this, we're going to chain together another linear interpolate. So if you wanted to, I just want to point this out. If you don't like how all of these wires are starting to really kind of go everywhere and cross over, and if it's becoming visually confusing, you can take something like a texture sample node that we have here, and you can create a duplicate of it. And since it's just a texture reference, that doesn't cost you anything. So we could just plug the red channel in here, and now we don't have those overlapping wires, so that could look a little bit cleaner. If you like working that way, you're certainly welcome to do so. So for instance, we could take this texture sample here. We could use this one if we wanted to plug this guy into the A, so that now we don't have quite so much overlapping. The only catch is we would also need to make sure that our texture coordinate drove this guy as well, because now we have two different copies of that wood. So I just kind of want to drive home. You can reorganize things by reusing references to a single texture if you like to work that way. It's entirely up to you. If it's a little less visually confusing to do that, then there you have it. Next, what we're gonna do is use the blue channel of this texture sample, which is really just another selection of panels. And we are going to linear interpolate between the result of this lerp and another color. So let's start off by creating our other color. I'm gonna hold down the 3 key and click once more. And let's make this one some shade of blue. So a little bit desaturated, a little, mostly pretty high on the value, but something about like that. So here's our blue color. Now I want to multiply that by the red channel just like we did a second ago. And again, if you want to, you can take your texture sample and you can duplicate it. There's nothing really wrong with this. So we'll take our red channel. Actually, let me start up by dragging from up here. And we can multiply. And there you go. So now we need to create a new linear interpolate. So we will drag a wire out from our first lerp and type lerp again and press enter. So this will be our value for black. So it's already plugged into A, which is perfect. And we'll take our result here and plug that into B. And if we want to, we can right-click and just start previewing. And it looks like he actually painted most things blue, which is not exactly what I wanted, to be perfectly honest. Oh, wait, I'm not driving alpha. Oh, well, you're welcome to laugh at me if you want to. Let's take our blue channel and plug that into alpha, and there we go. So some panels are blue, other panels are red, and some panels are just made of plain old wood. Now, let's start moving some things around for space. I'm just bar key dragging and then sliding these around. And then we'll take the result of this lerp. First, let's stop previewing it. And then we'll plug this into the B input of our little multiply node. And there we go. So now we have different colored wood panels scattered across the surface. Okay. So we're at 10 minutes in. Let's go ahead and take another break. And when we come back, we will comment this node network to make it a little easier for people to understand what's going on. And then we'll add a little bit of optional emission to make the little grout areas glow a bit. But that is going to wrap things up for this video. Thanks a lot.